Hi viewers, in 1991 Honda introduced an electronic control unit with a data link connector. Today I am going to use this connection to access the live data and find the difference between the base ignition timing and the spark advance displayed on my scanner.
Before warming up the engine and beginning any work, it could be a waste of time and money to try to adjust the ignition timing if some components are not working well. Usually I carry out a basic visual inspection. First, I removed the distributor cap and I looked for any pitting or oxidation on the terminals. Everything looked fine. I also checked the distributor rotor and I noticed a black deposit on the middle contact. I simply cleaned it with a rag. The four spark plugs wires were disconnected and inspected. The end clips were well connected and they look in good condition. At last, I removed the spark plugs to look at their condition. The four of them had a nice light gray color and the gap was within specification. All the parts were reinstalled and the engine was ready to be started. To be able to compare the base ignition timing and the ECU spark advance, I needed my timing light and my scanner. Because I'm curious, I wanted to see the spark advance and the RPM variations while the engine was warming up. I used my OBD1 adapter to connect the scanner with the DLC connector. Without starting the engine, I turned the key to the on position to power the ECU. By using this procedure, I kept the engine cold, and during that time, I was able to link the ECU with my scanner to access the live data outputs. Right after, I started the engine to warm it up and I completed my data selection. I was curious to observe the variations of the idle spark advance and the RPM from cold start to warmed up engine. After 6 or 7 minutes, the engine was fully warmed up and the idle speed stabilized around 750 RPM, which is normal setting in Canada for my 1.6 liter engine. To continue the investigation, I connected the timing light on the cylinder number 1 spark plug wire. In closed-loop condition, without the jumper wire connected on the service check connector, the ignition timing position observed with my timing light was the same as the spark advance displayed on my scanner. In that case, it means that the timing advance is fully controlled by the ECU. For the next step, I turned off the ignition switch and I connected the service check connector with the jumper wire. This connection disables some ignition timing controls applied by the computer. Soon after, I restarted the engine and I moved the shifter to the neutral position. When the jumper is connected and the engine is running, the ignition timing can be set with the timing light. Based on the induction signal from the spark plug wire number 1, the timing light flashes are used to align the middle red mark with the pointers. I noticed that my adjustment was around 1 or 2 degrees off. To correct it, the distributor mounting bolts were loosened and the distributor was rotated in small increments until I got my average 16 degree advance position. When the base ignition timing was properly adjusted, I secured the distributor. With the jumper wire connected, the ignition timing is only controlled by the ECU primary inputs. It means that the ECU is partially disabled and doesn't have the full control over the ignition timing. During the setting, my timing light was showing 16 degrees and my scanner was displaying a different spark advance to counteract the basic timing. But these displayed values were never applied to the base ignition timing. When the timing was completed, I turned off the ignition and I removed the jumper wire. In normal condition, my ECU is using the basic 16 degree crankshaft position as calibrated reference. Based on the selected ignition timing map, the ECU adds more advance or retard to override the ignition timing setting. In conclusion, the base ignition timing, combined with the added ECU corrections, can be referred as the spark advance displayed on my OBD2 scanner.
Yeah, the engine is fine and I think I'm gonna spend more time outside today.